Hi guys, this is Kate Quinn. Today we're going to show you how to use this template piece from the Mariner's Compass class and show you how to cut your background for the circle. So if you look right here, this dark bold line, that isn't our line. On the pattern piece, our actual templated line is this dotted line. And you can see the size down here. This is for the 15-inch diameter circle, which is what we have, and it will make a 17-inch block, and the block variance will be, you know, how wide it is. So, for example, if we cut it right here, or if we cut a piece where we have this much left over, this will make bigger than 17-inch block. Okay, right here on this edge, if you can see, mine is folded right there. Okay, so this is the corner right here. Okay. And if I use this one piece, which I'm gonna use for my peacock background, I'm gonna line it up on the fold on both sides. So I'll line it up on the fold here and on the fold here. So you may have to adjust it a little bit so that it's right on the line. And up here, right on the line. Okay, and so when we cut that, I've added in this 1/4-inch seam allowance. So there's our dot right there. And I templated this by putting my 1/4-inch foot right along that line and adding in this 1/4-inch seam right here. That gives us our cutting allowance. So you can take a white marker, just like this, and you're just going to mark along your line all the way along. Okay? And then what you'll do is you'll have that interior cutout right there. And I wouldn't worry about this outer edge right here. We'll square that up after we put the circle in it. So you're going to go ahead and mark through all this, and you're going to cut all 4 layers. Okay? I'm going to go ahead and prepare that and give you a chance to see what that outer circle looks like. Remember, this is the waist right here, and this is the part that you're working with. I mean, it looks kind of odd with the salvage and everything, but this is the area that we're keeping. Okay? And all we need out here, if we're going to put a border, is we just need our 1/4-inch seam allowance and a 1/4-inch seam allowance. We can have this as wide as we want. If we want a nice big open space for quilting, we could use a much larger piece. But this is a fat 1/4, okay? Now, if we're gonna piece our border, we're gonna have to do something a little bit different. So I'm gonna take this piece and I'm gonna bring it over here and show you what's going on this one. This one has a different pattern. You can see that it's got a stripe here in the center and it's got a little bit of an ombre to it. So rather than just cut out the circle, I pieced it. I'm going to cut 4 pieces, piece them in the center, and that way my ombre will rotate around the circle and it won't be like a big stripe right through the center and then top and bottom is dark. I'll get a little bit of ombre on each of those 4 corners. So I lined this up, and this was the right here, these pieces won't matter because it's going to be all pieced. But because of our template, the way it's set up, right there we're going to need a 1/4-inch. Okay, so it's lined up, and you'll see over here that this has got its 1/4-inch right here too. And the way that I did that is I just laid it on there, took my 1/4-inch marker, and added that in. And I added it in on both sides because each of those pieces are going to be pieced. So that will add a 1/4-inch seam allowance to each of the 4 pieces. Then I took a marker, you can see right there, there's my little Sharpie. I actually did use a Sharpie on this because none of that will show. That part is all well into the seam allowance and it was really easy to mark. So then see, I just cut that off. Alright, so if we're cutting 4 pieces to make a piece background, that's what we've got. We've got the 4 layers, 1/4-inch and 1/4-inch added on each side. We're going to cut out this center circle, and this is our waist, and this is the pieces that we're actually going to be piecing the circle into. Okay, and so the seam allowance is already there. Just to recap, if we were going to go ahead and do it as a single piece, we're just going to fold it into 1/4s, okay, lining up these seams right here really well. And if you can see, I used a Sharpie on this to make the line. And then you're just going to take your scissors. I just took a fabric scissors and I just held the fabric carefully and I cut it out on the line. And again, this piece is the waist and this piece will be the background portion that we're going to put our circle in. Alright, okay, so this is what that's going to look like. This piece right here is going to be pieced right into this circle right here. Okay, and this will be a whole circle, and then this one we will have to sew together in order to make that interior circle. Okay, so when we have the circle all sewn, you can see right here, that's our exterior circle. And it's not very wide, we don't really need it to be, especially if we're going to add a border. If you want it to be bigger, then you just need to use a larger square when you cut it. When we piece, one of the best things to do is to go ahead and press this open. The circle, the interior circle, is very bulky already, and we don't want to add especially bulk to one side, so this will distribute any fullness. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to press all of the seams of this background open like this, and then we're going to work on putting the circle inside. Alright, so you can see I've got the circle finished for both. Okay, so you can see the background and you can see the circle. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to take the paper out of the circle. The reason for that is it's really hard to manipulate the fabric on the bias with that paper in there. And when you're putting the circle inside the background, you definitely need to do that. Okay, so what we'll do is we'll take all of that paper out. This is just an opportunity to show you how easily that this paper does come out. Okay, so this is right here is just pressed in there. It's not sewn in there at all. So let me see if I can get the edge of it up with one hand. All right, so there it is. Okay, I'm just gonna pull that away just like that. Sometimes when you have the bulky seams, just kind of loosen it up with your finger like that, because you don't want to pull too much of the thread away. Okay, so you can see that that comes out, and we still have all of our nice pressing still in there. Then this piece is larger. Okay, this piece came from the center. It looks like maybe it's tacked in a little bit, so I'm just going to loosen that up with my fingers right there. So you can see how raggedy that is. So it got stitched in just a little bit close to the edge. So I'll just loosen the paper. I don't want to tear the stitching, I just want to loosen the paper. Okay? Alright, so go ahead and take out the paper from your circle when you're all ready. Your circle should be fully put together, minus the center. And we'll get all of those papers out, and then we'll start putting the circle into the background. Okay, so we're going to start piecing the circle into this background. I know it's curved piecing. Don't be alarmed. It's okay. We'll just take it really slow. So you see right there, that's the fold line where the center of the quarter is. So we're going to use that mark all the way around. We're going to use this right down here on the bottom, the fold line, and right here on the sides, you can see where it's folded. And we're going to use what I call the primary rays. That's this ray right here that is full size. And we only need four of them right now because we're matching quarters, so I'm going to use these blue ones right here, all these four. And their points are what we're going to worry about right now. Not going to worry about anything else, we're just going to match them up to the outside here, and we're going to set those quarters. You can check them with the Wonder Clip just like we did before. I set the quarter if I need to shift this in a little bit, or if I need to take up a little bit more. I'll shift the seam so that the quarter matches right there. Okay, because you do have a little bit of variance always with these points. So you've got to use your eyeball, and that quarter inch mark on the Wonder Clips will really help you. But don't be afraid to adjust a little bit, because it is bias. It can take a little bit of give when we shift it, and then when we block it out after we finish sewing it, we can make little adjustments to fullness by steaming it before we put that center circle in. Okay, and that's what stabilizes the rest of the circle. All right, so I'm gonna pin those and then I'm gonna show you what they look like. All right, guys, this is the first point. I have it Wonder Clipped. So you can see I've got the circle upright, and I'm gonna fold this background around like this to match the curve. So I'm gonna set it in so that the background is face up, and then when I pin it, I'm going to be pinning it like this along the circle. Okay, just like that. So that'll help you to orient your fabric. Circle is face up, and your background is face up, and then you're gonna lay it over with right sides together. So this is our first point, and you can see right there, that's pretty nice. Our point is not gonna be cut off right there, see? So that's perfect. So I'm gonna use that technique now, and I'm gonna go ahead and go around, and I'm gonna match this side point right here, just like that, and this top point, and this point. I'm gonna start with those, and then I'm gonna go ahead and work my array around the circle in quarter increments. So, for example, I'm gonna start with these four, and then the next time I'm gonna come around and I'm gonna match up these four. All right, guys, so I just wanna show where we are. So I've gone ahead and I've pinned on each of the primary rays, okay? I put two pins because I don't want any slippage from where my Wonder Clip was. So this is how I do it. I put the Wonder Clip on, I check the point, then when it's good and I feel comfortable with it on the quarter inch mark, then I pin it, and I'm going to take that off. So what you can see now is we've got this fullness that's left. Okay, so this is not a really big area, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of just go in the center here and distribute that fullness right along, and I'm going to go ahead and just pin it. This is one of the primary rays right here, this point right there, and this one right here. Okay, and what I wanted to show you is once you get that far, there's not very much fullness left. Okay, so what you'll see is when you distribute that fullness, this thing's gonna fit in there almost exactly. So can you see that? There's hardly any fullness once you put those 8 points in. So you should be able to pin that circle. You just distribute the fullness right at that second ray, that's this one. These outside ones are the short ones, and this one is the medium size ray. So we'll distribute the fullness, I pin that one, and then look what you got, hardly anything. You'll be able to get that right in there without too much trouble. It's not really a struggle. This larger circle is pretty easy to pin the two pieces together. It's the center circle that gives you a lot of trouble, which is why I tend to make a designer circle and applique on the top.